Well, this is my new wristwatch. It's the Yes Equilibrium. It's been developed by a company in California, and it's rather unusual for a wristwatch. It's got some unusual features. Firstly, you'll notice that black disc in the lower part of the dial. That is, in fact, the moon. At the moment, it's a new moon, so it's shown entirely in black here, but it does show an accurate representation of the moon as it goes through its phases. The yellow triangle shows that it's still waning. It's not completely a new moon yet. The triangle on the left will become yellow when the moon is waxing, and then the black disc will gradually develop yellow segments to show the growth of the moon. The two coloured rings around the outer edge of the dial, one orange and one yellow, they're also an unusual feature. The orange one shows the true solar day. The little dash just right of the top shows true solar noon, and the shaded area near the bottom shows night time. Now, where I live up in Orkney, at this time of year, night time is all twilight, so there's no black segment. There's just that dotted segment to show twilight. The yellow ring shows the lunar day, that is the moon's rising and setting. So the black area at the bottom, that's where the moon is below the horizon and therefore invisible. Well, it's invisible anyway because it's a new moon. The black dash at the top shows when the moon is at its highest point in the sky. The single hand is in fact an hour hand, which turns in 24 hours. 12 noon being at the top and midnight being at the bottom. Right, I'll now go through some of the features to show you what this watch can do. City data first. Aberdeen needs the location for the latitude and longitude, so I get the solar and lunar data accurately. Then it gives you the date. Goes back the time. You can zoom this on by pushing the button repeatedly. Latitude and longitude of Aberdeen, where I don't live, it's the nearest city in the memory. Time zone 0000, that means no offset from Greenwich Mean Time. Daylight saving time, euro. I don't know if we're exactly the same as the rest of Europe, but still. Day of the year and week number. Sorry, that hour hand is in the way, so you can't see it properly. Now, sun data. Sunrise 4:29. Zenith, that's solar high noon 13:14. Sunset 21:58. Civil twilight gives you the hours of civil twilight. Nautical twilight, I don't know why it's not shown here. Astronomical twilight, for some reason it's not shown in this particular setup. Moon data. Moonrise 3:50. Lunar high noon 12:34. Moonset 21:18. Luminous 1% because it's a new moon. Next new moon, I mean new moon 13th of July. Next full moon 27th of July. Home Aberdeen. Okay, I'll show you some other functions of this watch now. Daily alarm. 99 minute timer, that's just a countdown. Sunrise and sunset alarm, that sounds an alarm at sunset and again at sunrise. Cuckoo, well, that's not literally a cuckoo sound, it just means it bleeps on the hour. You can set it to sound between certain hours and not in the middle of the night if you want. Countdown or count up, that's just a time counter, so I can count the number of days and hours until a certain date or event, which is quite handy. Regatta alarm, I don't know what the heck that is, I don't use it. Oh, back to daily alarm again. Okay, back to time. When you go back to time, it says you're in Aberdeen, for some reason. Aberdeen is the nearest city to where I live, so it's where the watch has been set to. And this is what it looks like on my wrist. Big, isn't it? I put in my order for this watch in January, and it took till the end of June to get it, because it was pre-ordered before manufacture. It was bought through the Indiegogo scheme. The company needed investors before the watch was put into production. So when I ordered it, it still hadn't been made. But I'm very pleased with it.